mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line with all the other not quite, with all the never get it right. But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this time. 'Cause I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
When Moses had stage fright and David brought a rock to a sword fight, you picked 12 outsiders nobody would have chosen, and you changed the world. Well, the moral of the story is everybody's got a purpose. So when I hear that devil start talking to me, saying, who do you think you are? I say, I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
So let me go down, down, down in history as another blood-bought, faithful member of the family. And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. So let me go down, down, down in history.
Go down in history.
As another blood-bought, faithful member of the family.
That's all I ever wanna be.
And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
'Cause I'm just a nobody,
nobody.
Trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
Welcome, dear listeners, to another episode of Faith Foundation. Today is your day. We have back-to-back podcast series. So today we bring you a deeply moving and inspiring journey titled From Darkness to Light, Overcoming Depression and Addiction Through Faith. Depression and addiction, two words that carry a heavy weight, not only for me, but for a lot of people. As I've passed that, I came from addiction. I know what it's like. I fought with depression. I know what that's like. And that's why it's so important for me to share my story with you guys here today. And even though these two words carry such a heavy weight, they are not just conditions or states of being. They are battles that millions of people around the world fight every day. Battles that do not discriminate based on age, gender, social status. You know, they just don't, they're battles. And they don't discriminate. Battles that can leave one feeling trapped in a seemingly endless cycle of despair and hopelessness. But what if we told you right now, today, right this very minute, that there is a way out, a path that leads from the depths of the darkness into a warm, embracing light, a path paved with faith? What if I told you, coming from a former addict, a former person who fought depression, what if I told you that I, too, experienced the way out? That I, too, was in the darkness and thought of suicide and depression and lived on the streets in the cold and slept under a bridge, all because of my addiction. Not knowing where the next fix was going to come from or anything like that. But what if I told you there was a way out? Well, today, I'm going to show you how to get out. And I'm going to show you the way out. See, faith is more than just a word. It is a beacon of hope in the stormy seas of life. It is an anchor when we waves of despair threaten to pull us under. It is strength we find within ourselves. We feel like we've nothing left. So, in today's episode, as we delve into the transformative power of faith in overcoming depression and addiction, I want us to understand that we walk together through the valley of shadows and emerge into the sunlight together as one, the body of Christ. Their spirits renewed, hearts filled with hope. These stories are resonance, courage, and redemption of how we can bear testament to the healing power of faith. How we, as addicts and depression, suffer from depression. Now, it is our stories that remind us that no matter how dark the day may seem, there's always a dawn waiting on the other side. So whether you're personally grappling with these issues or watching a loved one struggle with, we invite you to join us on this journey. A journey from darkness to light. From despair to hope. From addiction and depression to recovery and renewal. Together, let us explore how faith can guide us through our darkest moments and lead us towards a brighter tomorrow. Stay tuned, dear listeners, as we embark on this enlightening journey. Remember, you're not alone in your struggles. And with your faith as your compass, you too can find a way from darkness to light.
Out of purpose. So when I hear that devil start talking to me, saying, who do you think you are? I say, I'm just a nobody. Trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul.
Welcome to Faith Foundation, HCV Ministry Podcast. I am your host, Associate Pastor Joseph Holmes. So before we start today, a couple of announcements. I want to announce our latest book from me and Brother Johnny Embry. The book is titled The Spiritual Journey: Growing Closer to God and Rejecting Satan's Lies. Now, this is the first book of a 5-book series called the Spiritual Journey Series, Embracing God's Light and Defeating Darkness. So, this is book one. It's a great book. It's out on Kindle. It's out in paperback. It's out in hardcover. It's at Barnes & Noble's. Get it today. Put it to your library or send it to a loved one who's having difficulties in their spiritual journey. It's a great book, 252 pages. Of nothing but self-help Christian knowledge on how to overcome Satan's lies and deceptions and how to grow closer to God. So today, check it out. If you have Amazon or Kindle Unlimited. It costs you nothing to download. We're trying to get the word of God out there, people. So check it out. Kindle Unlimited, $0. Or if you don't have it, it's 99 cents to download. $12.99 paperback. $19.99 hardcover. All the money goes to the proceeds to the ministry. Help us fund this ministry and get the word of Jesus, Yeshua, Messiah out. Now, how can you find us? Just go to Amazon.com and type in rev.johnnyembry or rev.josephholmes. And there you will find us and all of our books. From that point on, then you can just decide which books you want. But I really highly suggest this new release. It was highly anticipated. It's potential to be number one bestseller. Get your first copy, be the first one, and spread the word about it. Share it with your loved ones, with friends who may be having problems that you know of, that need some spiritual journey, that need a little encouraging in their life, someone who you think may need to grow closer to God, and who needs to stop getting away from who are in this world, needs to get away from this world. Share this book with them. Make a great gift. That being said, let us pray so we can start today's word. Let's bow our heads and pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you today with hearts filled with gratitude, seeking your guidance and wisdom as we embark on this journey of faith and healing. We thank you for the opportunity to gather together in your name through the Faith Foundation podcast, brought to you by HCB Ministries, where we can explore the share and the transformative power of faith in overcoming the darkness and depressions of addiction. Lord, we acknowledge that many of us have experienced the depths of despair and hopelessness that come with depression and addiction. We have felt the weight of these burdens pressing down on us, threatening to consume us in darkness. But we know that with you, there is always a light at the end of the tunnel. Your love and grace are our beacons of hope, shining brightly to lead us out of the shadows and into the glorious light. As we delve into the topic of overcoming depression and addiction through faith, we ask for your presence to be with us every step of the way. We ask that you grant us courage and comfort so we can confront our struggles head on, knowing that you are our ever-present source of strength and comfort. Help us to lean on you in times of weakness, trusting in your promise to never leave nor forsake us. We lift up those who are currently battling with depression and addiction, struggling to see the light amidst of darkness that surrounds them. May you feel the loving embrace in their moments of despair, drawing them closer to you and fulfilling their hearts with hope and peace. Give them endurance to preserve through their trials, knowing that you are with them every step of the way. Father, we pray for the speakers and the listeners who will be sharing their stories and insights on today's episode. May their word be a source of encouragement and inspiration to all who listen, planting seeds of faith and healing the hearts of those who are in need. Our testimonies shine as a light on the path to recovery and restoration, reminding all of us of your power and your grace to transform lives. As we conclude this prayer, we surrender ourselves in divine will, trusting your infinite wisdom and love to guide us through this podcast episode. May our minds be open, our hearts be receptive, and our spirits be uplifted by the message of hope and redemption that we are about to receive. In your holy name, Yeshua Messiah, we pray. And we all said, amen. I want to give a shout out to our affiliates and special sponsors, Hootsuite.com and thechristianbookstore.com, where all your Christian needs can be found and met. Just go to our website, www.hcbministries.org, That's www.hcbministries.org. And click at the bottom, scroll to the bottom of the page where you'll see the logos, the Hootsuite logos, which is for all your social media needs, and the Christian bookstore for all your Christian needs. You'll see the banners and the logos. Just click on them. It'll take you right to them for a special offer from them, from us, HCB Ministries. Those are our affiliates, and we want to welcome them as of yesterday. We thank them for affiliating themselves with us and us feeling being able to affiliate ourselves with them. So, from darkness to light, how many of us have ever expressed from darkness to light? Overcoming depression and addiction through faith. See, depression and addiction are two of the most challenging issues that many people face today. They can affect anyone, regardless of age, gender, or social status. These problems can be deliberating. They lead to a life of misery, which can be heard or escaped from. And if you have a testimony today or any other time, please email us our testimony. Next week, we'll be sharing testimonies that we've received. So email us your testimony so we can receive it and share it with everybody else at hcb@hcbministry.org. That is hcb@hcbministry.org. And in the subject title, put testimony. So that way we can share it with everyone else. You know, because many people have found that strength, hope, and a new lesson on life by turning their faith during their darkest moments. This podcast, we're going to explore how faith can hear stories and help those who are struggling with depression and addiction. We will hear stories from myself, how I have gone through these challenging and come out on the other side. So if you're a loved one who's struggling with this, let's continue, sit back, relax, and enjoy the podcast. So my journey into darkness, struggling with depression and faith, in the depths of despair and hopelessness, my journey starts as I was a racehorse jockey, making lots of money, out there making $50,000 in a month, living the fast life, living the worldly life. Although I had always believed in God, don't get it twisted. It's not, I never lost faith in God. But somehow, somewhere along the way, I just lost, not faith, but I just lost myself in the things of this world. And it was the things of this world that got me caught up. And it was the things of this world that had me put my faith on a shelf because things were going great. I felt I didn't need it. Why do I need faith? I have the things of the world, right? With all this wrapped up into a present, nicely knitted, fast cars, fast life, women, drugs. I was a professional athlete living the life. Until one day when the ultimate unthinkable happened, and within 5 seconds, all that was taken from me. Just 5 seconds. It was all taken from me. And it started my life on a downward spiral that was ultimately out of control. I lost my family, my wife, my kids. Got on drugs. Lost my home. Lost all my money. Lost everything. And I wondered where God was during this whole time. He was there with me, but we're going to get into that. But as I was worried more about drugs and horses and racing, I was worried less about God. So instead of making God my number one, I was making things of the world, number one. And when he got me, when I got hurt, and I lost everything. It's like Job, I lost everything that I could imagine. Depression wrapped its icy things around my mind. Just my mind whispered cruel lies and dragged me down to the pits of emptiness. The weight on my chest made it hard to breathe. And the days blurred into a never-ending cycle of numbness and pain. See, addiction is like a shadowy companion. You know, it's promised an escape from the unbearable reality of my existence. It offered fleeting moments of relief, but only to tighten the grip with each passing day. My kids felt became less important. Eventually, the horses even became less important. And even my career as a jockey became less important. But what came important was the deceiving and lies of Satan, the depression and the addiction of how I was going to get high the next day, or how I was going to stay high. See, as I navigated through the treacherous waters of mental illness and substance abuse, I felt lost, alone. The darkness that threatened to consume me entirely, leaving me teetering on the edge of oblivion or suicide. But even in my darkest moments, a flicker of hope remained. I remembered I had Jesus on the shelf. A tiny ember of faith that refused to be extinguished. See, through half a dozen of despairs, I begin to see a glimmer of light on the horizon. And it was in that faint at first, barely perceptible mist of maybe the darkness, but it grew stronger with each step I took towards it. My journey into the darkness was not yet over, but I clung to the light of a lifeline, knowing that I held the promise of redemption and renewal. Little did I know that this glimmer of light would lead me on a path of transforming and healing, guiding me out of the abyss and depression and my addiction. But my journey was far from easy. I wound up getting in trouble, wound up going to jail, wound up being going to prison for drugs, and it was filled with twists and turns and setbacks and victories. I found the Lord when I was in prison. I did my drug rehab. I got out on probation, did my probation successfully, did my drug rehab successfully. And even going back to riding. But through faith and perseverance, I thought I emerged from the darkness, only to find myself suddenly back in it. So as I share my story of overcoming with others who may be struggling in the shadows, know that once we think we're out of it and that God has brought us out of this, I had to find my faith again. And I hit my knees again and prayed, God, take this from me. And it was then I was arrested again 5 minutes later after I had prayed. 5 minutes after I had prayed, I was arrested again. I was like, God, you didn't have to do it this way, did you? He says, yes, my son, I did. And I learned then, I said, please take this addiction and this depression away from me. And he did. But I learned through all of this that in order for it to work, we must constantly serve him. Every day that we live, we constantly serve him. Every day that we wake up, we have to be reminded to 10:31, do what we do for the glory of God. We cannot let the world sneak back into our lives and ultimately grab a hold of us, because that's what Satan wants us to believe. oh, you're out of it. Don't worry. Here, occasional drink. Or here, you know, you can occasionally get high or hang out with your old friends. Or you don't have to do drugs. Just hang out with your old friends. Bad company corrupts good character. We see this. We must make a pivotal moment in our lives where we decide. Do we choose faith in God? Or do we choose the things of this world and our old friends? See, the turning point in the depths of my struggles was with depression and addiction. I had reached the turning point where that illuminating a path towards healing and transformation, it was during my darkest moments that I found solace in faith and discovered a glimmer of hope that would ultimately guide me towards recovery. Faith becoming my anchor provided me with a sense of purpose and belief. See, in something greater than myself, in the midst of chaos and despair, I found a source of strength that comforts, that allowed me to navigate the turbulent waters of my emotions. Through prayer and reflection and connecting with Yeshua, Messiah, I begin to see a light shining through the darkness. This newfound faith instilled in me a sense of resilience and determination, being born again. Wow. Let me say being born again. To overcome my struggles and embrace a life filled with hope, positivity. We must have the hope and positivity in life to move forward. See, that is how our lives work. And that's how we work in Jesus through Yeshua Messiah. You know, the journey from darkness to light, it's not easy, nor will it ever be an easy one. And there were many obstacles along the way. However, by holding on to my faith and trusting in the power of hope and entrusting in Yeshua, Messiah, and my prayer life and my relationship, I was able to transcend my circumstances and emerge stronger on the other side. Now, finding faith in my darkest moments was truly a turning point in my life, marking the beginning of a transformational journey towards healing and recovery and a renewed sense of purpose. Renewed sense of purpose. You must have a renewed sense of purpose every day. Because if you don't, the world will creep in. It is something that must be done every day. Every day you wake up, you must renew your sense of purpose. You must renew your relationship with Yeshua Messiah. It must renew your relationship with God. You must renew your relationship with your prayers. See, the role in overcoming depression and addiction, faith can play a powerful role in the journey of overcoming depression and addiction. For many individuals, turning their faith provides a source of strength, hope, and during these challenging times, believing in a higher power or a purpose can offer comfort and solace. When facing the depths of despair and the grip of addiction, faith can serve as a guiding light, providing a sense of meaning and direction in life. It can instill a sense of purpose and a belief that there is a greater plan beyond one's current struggles. See, through prayer, meditation, and seeking spiritual guidance, individuals can find inner peace and a sense of connection to something greater than themselves, as I did. Moreover, faith can foster a sense of community and support. Being part of a faith-based community in AA, Bible studies, church, that can offer a network of caring individuals who provide encouragement, understanding, and companionship along with your journey to recovery. This sense of belonging and acceptance can be instrumental in breaking the cycle of isolation, which is very important, and the shame that often accompanies depression and addiction. We must overcome that. We do that by with the people that we surround us with. Make new friends, people. Go out there. You know, ultimately, faith can serve as a beacon of hope in darkness, guiding individuals towards healing, transformation, a renewed sense of purpose. See, by embracing our faith and leaning on its teachings and principles, we can find the strength and courage to overcome the challenges of depression and addiction. And we can emerge into the light of a brighter and healthier future through our faith, through Yeshua, Messiah. You know, he wants us to become better. We can't let the depression and the addiction consume us and let the world consume us. Let's look around and see what we have around us. We see rumors of wars. We see earthquakes happening, 700 earthquakes. We see all this happening. Pestles, we see COVID-19 hit, we see wars, our government falling apart, America falling apart. America, are we ready for what is fixing to happen? Are you ready for Yeshua the Messiah to come back? Are you ready for all this? Don't let the world, the burden of the world, increase your depression, but actually use that to your advantage. To help you come out of depression and addiction in the knowing that Yeshua Messiah, the second coming, is at hand, and soon we will be with the Lord. But in order for us to be with him, we must first follow him. We must first accept him into our hearts. See, the first step to embrace with acknowledge and to embrace like my struggles and accepting that I needed help was the self-awareness of the pivotal moment that allowed me to confront my inner demons and seek support from loved ones and professionals and God. Yes, and God. Next, I prioritize my mental and physical well-being by adopting a healthy habits such as regular exercise, mindfulness practice, and proper nutrition. These lifestyles change not only to improve my overall health, but also to nurture a sense of self-care and self-worth. We must believe in ourselves. Additionally, I delved into the therapy and counseling to address the root causes of the depression and addiction, but through retrospect and guidance, I explored past traumas, learning coping mechanisms, and developing a resilience in the face of adversity, which was, you know, I developed how to handle things through faith and prayer. Moreover, my faith played a profound role in my journey towards healing, connecting with my spiritual beliefs, providing me with hope, strength, and a renewed sense of purpose. I may no longer be a jockey, but I'm still out there with prayer and meditation and reflecting, becoming intriguing tools to my recovery process. I am offering solace and guidance during a moment of darkness to others, showing others that, yes, I may not be a professional athlete, no more making tons of money, but I am a warrior of Christ, a pastor who is out to save lives, to help you understand that it's not over yet, that your depression and your addiction, it's just the beginning of your new life. It's time to put it down. Break free from the chains of depression and addiction. And you do this by requiring perseverance, patience, and willingness. And know that Rome was not built overnight, brick by brick. To embrace vulnerability by taking these steps towards healing and recovering. We not only find our inner peace to be liberation, but also discovered a newfound sense of empowerment and resilience to navigate life's challenges with grace and courage. How many of us want to put down that depression? How many of us want to put down that addiction? We can do that through our faith. Very easy. And we can also do it by finding support. Your AA meeting, your NA meeting, go to those meetings. Go to a Bible study. Go to your church. Finding support in community is one's faith can be transformative and healing. See, experiencing for those struggling with depression and addiction in the depths of despair, it is often the unwavering support of a community bonded by faith that can provide solace and strength to carry on. See, through shared beliefs, prayers, and encouragement, individuals can find the sense of belonging and understanding that transcends their personal struggles. It overcomes their personal struggles, whether it's through attending religious services, joining support groups within their faith community, or simply reaching out to fellow believers and guidance to maybe power a communal support in times of darkness that cannot be underestimated. See, faith can serve as a guiding light, offering hope or sense of purpose to navigating the challenges and despairs for addiction by leaning on the pillars of their faith and surrounding themselves with the supportive community. Individuals can find strength and perseverance, heal, and ultimately emerge from the shadows into the light of renewal. You may say, well, Pastor, that's great, but I'm an addict or I'm suffering depression, but I have no way to find support or community. I have no way to get there. I have no ride to go to support groups. I don't know anybody. Well, if you're listening to this podcast, yes, you do. Send us an email that you'd like to get connected. hcb@hcbministries.org. That's hcb@hcbministries.org. Or look online. There's even NA groups, AA groups who are online that you can go to meetings online as well. Be sure to check those out. You know, so there's many ways that we can foster our addiction and overcome our addiction as well as overcoming our depression with addiction. There's many different ways, you know, so let us understand that. Let us also understand that prayer and meditation, it played a pivotal role in my journey from darkness to light. It guided me through the shadows of depression and addiction towards a path of healing and renewal in depth of despair when it felt like there was no way out, turning to faith and seeking solace in prayer provided me with a sense of peace and comfort, suppressed every understanding that I could imagine. When I got depressed, I prayed. When I wanted to get high, I prayed. You know, and they say with the human mind, 10 minutes of thinking of something else, your mind, your body forgets about the addiction for that moment. Well, true enough, but if you spend 10 minutes with just the Lord, our Yeshua, Messiah, our Lord and Jesus Christ, spend 10 minutes with him in prayer, there's nothing you can't overcome. So next time you're depressed, try it. Get on your knees in just 10 minutes of your day praying to him while you're depressed and ask him, talk to him like a best friend, just talk to him and see where it goes. Or the next time you want to get high or stick a needle in your arm or do another shot or do another hit because you can't handle your life, get on your knees and pray for 10 minutes. See where that takes you, because through the practice of meditation and prayer, I found a quiet space within myself where I could confront my inner demons and tell them, get behind me, Satan, for you don't know what you're doing. You have no authority over me, I acknowledged all my struggles and cultivated a sense of mindfulness that allowed me to stay present in the Lord. By grounding myself in prayer, I connected with Yeshua Messiah, Jesus Christ, that offered me strength, hope, and courage to face my challenges head on, and I was okay for a short amount of time. I needed it again. I felt like I wanted to get high again. There for a moment, I survived minute by minute, 10 minutes by 10 minutes, an hour by an hour. I survived it through prayer. Oh, I got yoga high. Oh, I'm so depressed. Oh, I want to miss this. Oh, I want to die. I get down on my knees and I pray 10 minutes and then it occupied my mind long enough to forget it. Pretty soon, 10 minutes led on to 20 minutes. 20 minutes led to an hour. 1 hour led to 2 hours. You get the picture. 1 day led to 2 days. Pretty soon prayer took over and the devil was gone. See, that's what I'm talking about, the power of prayer and meditation. In my recovery, I cannot overstate the spiritual practices that became my anchors in the storm, provided me with a sense of purpose, guidance, and resilience to navigate the rocky terrain of my mental health journey in moments of doubt and despair. I tuned in to Yeshua Messiah and turned to prayer for reassurance, drawing upon my wellspring of faith that sustained me through the darkest of nights. And it can also sustain you through the darkest of nights. Just pray, people. And, you know, as I reflected on the transformative impact of prayer and meditation in my life, I realized that these practices not only served as tools for self-care and introspection, but also as a gateway to deeper connection with my Lord Yeshua Messiah, Jesus Christ. Through the simple act of prayer, I found that lifeline to hope, a beacon of light that illuminated the path towards recovery and wholeness that was once so darkened by despair and depression and addiction and drugs, where I thought there was no light. See, embracing the power of prayer and meditation, I discovered a source of strength within myself that transcended and illuminated my circumstances with faith as my compass and my meditation as Jesus Yeshua as the guide. I embarked on a journey of healing and transformation that led me from the depths of despair to the heights of redemption. Today, I stand as a testament to enduring power of prayer and meditation in overcoming adversity and embracing the light that shines with us all. It is He who shines through us. But it is us who can save those from darkness. All those that you know that are addicted for drugs or depression, let His light shine through you and you shine through them and pull them out. See, don't think it's going to be all easy and everything, because I learned that life is full of ups and downs, setbacks, an inevitable part of a journey we face with challenges such as despair and addiction. It can be easy to lose hope and feel overwhelmed. However, it is during these difficult times that staying strong in faith can make all the difference in the world, especially now. Overcoming setbacks requires a steadfast belief in something greater than yourself. We must have something greater than ourselves. For many, faith serves as a guiding light, providing solace, strength, and a sense of purpose through faith. Individuals can find the courage to persevere even when the road ahead seems dark and uncertain. So staying connected in faith is not always easy. especially in the face of adversity in the world today where it's unpopular to believe in Yeshua, Messiah, Jesus Christ, how church is unpopular, Christian is unpopular, and for us to stay strong in that faith, it's not always easy. It requires trust in a higher power in Yeshua, Messiah, the Lord, our living God, the true and one living God, a willingness to surrender control to that God, to Yeshua, Messiah, and a commitment to self-reflection and growth, not just one-time commitment, but a daily commitment, a daily growth, a daily self-reflection. And by turning to faith during challenging times, individuals can tap into the wellspring of the inner strength and the resilience that can help them navigate even the darkest days. If you wake up today and you say 10:31, you wake up, or everything you do is 10:31. Okay, well, I'm going to go do this. Ask yourself, is that 10:31? Does it glorify God? Am I living to glorify God? And by doing that, you ultimately overcome setbacks and you stay strong in faith. And that's a journey of self-discovery and spiritual growth that you have yet to find in a succumbing of peace and joy that is beyond your imagination, beyond your thinking. And by holding on to faith as a beacon of hope and guidance, individuals can find the strength to overcome their struggles and emerge stronger and more resilient on the other side. True? See, shining a bright light through yourself and letting Yeshua Messiah shine through you, and also sharing personal experiences can be incredibly powerful and inspiring. When it comes to overcoming challenges such as despair and addiction, sharing your story can offer hope and encouragement to others who may be going through similar struggles by opening up about your own journey. You not only provide a sense of solidarity to those facing similar battles, but you also break the stigma surrounding mental health and addiction issues. Sharing your story can help others realize that they are not alone in their struggles, and that there is a light at the end of the tunnel. It can serve as a beacon of hope for those who may feel lost, overwhelmed by their circumstances. Your experience, triumphs, and setbacks can offer valuable insights and lessons to others who are on the journey towards healing and recovery, and even to those who aren't. We must be strong, not for ourselves, but for everyone else around us too. And we do that by sharing our story. We create a platform of empathy, understanding, and connection. We can inspire others to seek help, reach out for support, and believe in their own ability to overcome adversity. See, your story has the power to touch hearts, change lives, and make a positive impact in the lives of those who need it most. Embrace the opportunity to share your journey, your testimony from darkness to light. It's a great one. It's a profound one. It's one that can change lives. As it changed yours, let it change others. And let your story be a source of strength and inspiration for others on the path of healing and wholeness. Don't let it stop there. Let it continue to grow. Continue to fester. Let your story be the light for others. You know, embrace a new life of light. You know, joy through faith is a transformation journey that offers hope and healing to those struggling with depression and addiction. For many individuals, faith serves as a guiding light that illuminates the path towards recovery and renewal. It provides solace in times of darkness, strength in moments of weakness, and a sense of purpose and meaning amidst chaos, right? So through faith, individuals are able to find a deeper connection to something greater than themselves. Whether it be Yeshua, Messiah, a higher power, spiritual beliefs, or a community of like-minded individuals, this connection fosters a sense of belonging and support that is crucial in the journey towards healing. Faith offers a beacon of hope in times of despair, reminding individuals that they are never alone and that there is always a possibility for a brighter tomorrow. It instills a sense of resilience and perseverance, empowering individuals to overcome the challenges they face and embrace a new way of living filled with light, joy, and purpose. By embracing faith, people, we can foster a source of strength and guidance that individuals can embark on transformative and transform their journey as well. Through our light, as self-discovery, healing, and renewal. If I can do it, you can do it. If he can do it, I can do it. See, it provides the foundation which a new life of light and joy can be built by offering a path toward a brighter and more fulfillment and more fulfilling future. See, I want us to understand that in order to help those who are lost, or even ourselves, sharing our journey or creating a journey for us, maybe create you a journey journal, which is every step of your journey, you write it down. Keep a journal of your steps towards recovery, as your steps towards beating addiction and depression. And keep a journal from your darkness to light. And you could title it My Darkness, From My Darkness to My Light, or whatever you choose. But that can be a powerful way to inspire others who are struggling in the same challenges. Be openly discussing how faith played a pivotal part or role in a recovery from depression to addiction. Write a book. Share your journal. Share your insights of how you have the opportunity that offers hope and healing to those whom you feel lost or alone, and how your own battles became victories, and how your faith-based recovery is a deeply personal transformation processed by that can believe in individuals, see, with a sense of purpose, strength, and guidance as we navigate our way towards healing by sharing our experiences and in the ways in which our faith is supported on us and our journey, we can help those others see that there is a light. We can be that light. We can be the Bible that someone may never read. We can be the Jesus that someone may never see. And ultimately, we can be the light at the end of the tunnel, and that they are not alone in their struggles. So through your words and actions today, as we move forward in this podcast and as we come to a close, you have the power to inspire others to embark on their own path towards healing and renewal by offering a message of hope, faith, and you can help individuals and offer to find their strength with themselves to overcome their challenges and emerge stronger and more resilient to the other side. Let us encourage people to enjoy our story and to share our story as the potential to become a beacon of light for those who are still searching for the way out of the darkness, guiding them towards a brighter and more hopeful future. If you would like to share your testimony, I highly encourage you. Shoot us an email with your testimony, hcb at hcbministries.org. That's hcb at hcbministries.org. We would love to share your testimony. Now, with that concluding our podcast today, we would like to close in prayer. So if everybody bow their head with me and pray. Heavenly Father, we come to the end of this episode of Faith Foundation Podcast. We lift up our hearts and voices to you in prayer. We thank you for being our guiding light in times of darkness, for showing us the way from despair to hope, and for being our strength in moments of weakness. Today, we have delved into the topics of overcoming depression and addiction through faith, and we have been reminded of the power of your love and grace in transforming lives. Lord, we pray for all those who are battling with depression and addiction. We ask for your healing touch to be upon them, to lift the heavy burdens they carry, and to fill them with your peace that surpasses all understandings. Help them to see that the light at the end of the tunnel, to hold on to hope, and to know that they are never alone, for you are always with them. We pray for those who are struggling in darkness, that they may find strength and reach out for help to seek treatment and to lean on to their faith for support. May they be surrounded by loving and caring individuals who will walk alongside them on their journey to recovery. Give them the courage to face their challenges head on, and perseverance to never give up, knowing that with you, all things are possible. Philippians 4:13. Lord, we also pray for the families and the loved ones those who are battling depression and addiction. Help them to be strong and supportive, to show understanding and patience, and to never lose faith in the transformation that you can bring about their loved ones' lives. Grant them the wisdom and guidance in how to best help and encourage those who are struggling, and fill their hearts with compassion and empathy. As we conclude this episode, as we ask for your blessings on all those who have listened today, may the words spoken and the stories shared inspired and encourage them in their own journeys of faith. May they find comfort in knowing that there is always hope, always a way out of darkness, and always a light to shining bright to guide them home. We thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to come together in fellowship, to struggle and to share our struggles and the triumphs, and to be reminded of your unwavering love for us. May this podcast continue to be a beacon of hope and a source of strength to all who listen. In your holy, precious name, Yeshua Messiah, the one and only Jesus Christ, we pray, and we all said, Amen. From IHCB Ministries Faith Foundation Podcast, we're grateful for your listenership. I'm Pastor Joseph Holmes, and privileged to be your host for this podcast.
Why you ever chose me has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line, with all the other not quite, with all the never get it right. But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this time. 'Cause I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
When Moses had stage fright, and David brought a rock to a sword fight, You picked 12 outsiders nobody would have chosen, and you changed the world. Well, the moral of the story is everybody's got a purpose. So when I hear that devil start talking to me, saying, who do you think you are? I say, I'm just a nobody, trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
So let me go down, down, down in history as another blood-bought faithful member of the family. And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. So let me go down, down, down in history.
Go down in history.
As another blood-bought, faithful member of the family.
That's all I ever wanna be.
And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
'Cause I'm just a nobody,
nobody.
Trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
Welcome, dear listeners, to another episode of Faith Foundation. Today is your day. We have back-to-back podcast series. So today we bring you a deeply moving and inspiring journey titled From Darkness to Light, Overcoming Depression and Addiction Through Faith. Depression and addiction, two words that carry a heavy weight, not only for me, but for a lot of people. As I've passed that, I came from addiction. I know what it's like. I fought with depression. I know what that's like. And that's why it's so important for me to share my story with you guys here today. And even though these two words carry such a heavy weight, they are not just conditions or states of being. They are battles that millions of people around the world fight every day. Battles that do not discriminate based on age, gender, social status. You know, they just don't, they're battles. And they don't discriminate. Battles that can leave one feeling trapped in a seemingly endless cycle of despair and hopelessness. But what if we told you right now, today, right this very minute, that there is a way out, a path that leads from the depths of the darkness into a warm, embracing light, a path paved with faith. What if I told you, coming from a former addict and former person who fought depression, what if I told you that I, too, experienced the way out? That I, too, was in the darkness and thought of suicide and depression and lived on the streets in the cold and slept under a bridge, all because of my addiction. Not knowing where the next fix was going to come from or anything like that, but what if I told you there was a way out? Well, today, I'm going to show you how to get out. And I'm going to show you the way out. See, faith is more than just a word. It is a beacon of hope in the stormy seas of life. It is an anchor when we waves of despair threaten to pull us under. It is strength we find within ourselves. We feel like we've nothing left. So, in today's episode, as we delve into the transformative power of faith in overcoming depression and addiction, I want us to understand that we walk together, through the valley of shadows and emerge into the sunlight together as one, the body of Christ. Their spirits renewed, hearts filled with hope. These stories are resonance, courage, and redemption of how we can bear testament to the healing power of faith. How we, as addicts in depression, suffer from depression. Now, it is our stories that remind us that no matter how dark the day may seem, there's always a dawn waiting on the other side. So whether you're personally grappling with these issues or watching a loved one struggle with, we invite you to join us on this journey. A journey from darkness to light. From despair to hope. From addiction, depression, to recovery and renewal. Together, let us explore how faith can guide us through our darkest moments and lead us towards a brighter tomorrow. Stay tuned, dear listeners, as we embark on this enlightening journey. Remember, you're not alone in your struggles. And with your faith as your compass, you too can find a way from darkness to light.
Got a purpose. So when I hear that devil start talking to me, saying, who do you think you are? I say, I'm just a nobody.
Welcome to Faith Foundation, HCB Ministry Podcast. I am your host, Associate Pastor Joseph Holmes. So before we start today, a couple of announcements. I want to announce our latest book from me and Brother Johnny Embry. The book is titled The Spiritual Journey, Growing Closer to God and Rejecting Satan's Lies. Now, this is the first book of a 5-book series called The Spiritual Journey Series, Embracing God's Light and Defeating Darkness. So, this is book one. It's a great book. It's out on Kindle. It's out in paperback. It's out in hardcover. It's at Barnes & Noble's. Get it today. Put it to your library or send it to a loved one who's having difficulties in their spiritual journey. It's a great book, 252 pages of nothing but self-help Christian knowledge on how to overcome Satan's lies and deceptions and how to grow closer to God. So today, check it out. If you have Amazon or Kindle Unlimited, it costs you nothing to download. We're trying to get the word of God out there, people. So check it out. Kindle Unlimited, $0. Or if you don't have it, it's 99 cents to download, $12.99 paperback, $19.99 hardcover. All the money goes to the proceeds to the ministry. Help us fund this ministry and get the word of Jesus, Yeshua, Messiah out. Now, how can you find us? Just go to Amazon.com and type in rev.johnnyembry or rev.josephholmes, and there you will find us and all of our books. From that point on, then you can just decide which books you want, but I really highly suggest this new release. It was highly anticipated. It's potential to be number one bestseller. Get your first copy, be the first one, and spread the word about it. Share it with your loved ones, with friends who may be having problems that you know of, that need some spiritual journey, that need a little encouraging in their life, someone who you think may need to grow closer to God and who needs to stop getting away from who are in this world, needs to get away from this world. Share this book with them. Make a great gift. That being said, let us pray so we can start today's word. Let's bow our heads and pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you today with hearts filled with gratitude, seeking your guidance and wisdom as we embark on this journey of faith and healing. We thank you for the opportunity to gather together in your name through the Faith Foundation podcast, brought to you by HCV Ministries, where we can explore the share and the transformative power of faith in overcoming the darkness and depressions of addiction. Lord, we acknowledge that many of us have experienced the depths of despair and hopelessness that come with depression and addiction. We have felt the weight of these burdens pressing down on us, threatening to consume us in darkness. But we know that with you, there is always a light at the end of the tunnel. Your love and grace are our beacons of hope, shining brightly to lead us out of the shadows and into the glorious light. As we delve into the topic of overcoming depression and addiction through faith, we ask for your presence to be with us every step of the way. We ask that you grant us courage and comfort so we can confront our struggles head on, knowing that you are our ever-present source of strength and comfort. Help us to lean on you in times of weakness, trusting in your promise to never leave nor forsake us. We lift up those who are currently battling with depression and addiction, struggling to see the light amidst the darkness that surrounds them. May you feel the loving embrace in their moments of despair, drawing them closer to you and fulfilling their hearts with hope and peace. Give them endurance to preserve through their trials, knowing that you are with them every step of the way. Father, we pray for the speakers and the listeners who will be sharing their stories and insights on today's episode. May their word be a source of encouragement and inspiration to all who listen, planting seeds of faith and healing the hearts of those who are in need. Our testimonies shine as a light on the path to recovery and restoration, reminding all of us of your power and your grace to transform lives. As we conclude this prayer, we surrender ourselves in divine will, trusting your infinite wisdom and love to guide us through this podcast episode. May our minds be open, our hearts be receptive, and our spirits be uplifted by the message of hope and redemption that we are about to receive. In your holy name, Yeshua Messiah, we pray. And we all said, amen. I want to give a shout out to our affiliates and special sponsors, Hootsuite.com and thechristianbookstore.com, where all your Christian needs can be found and met. Just go to our website, www.hcbministries.org. That's www.hcbministries.org. And click at the bottom, scroll to the bottom of the page where you'll see the logos, the Hootsuite logos, which is for all your social media needs, and the Christian bookstore for all your Christian needs. You'll see the banners and the logos. Just click on them. It'll take you right to them for a special offer from them, from us, HCB Ministries. Those are our affiliates, and we want to welcome them as of yesterday. We thank them for affiliating themselves with us and us being able to affiliate ourselves with them. So, from darkness to light, how many of us have ever expressed from darkness to light? Overcoming depression and addiction through faith. See, Depression and addiction are two of the most challenging issues that many people face today. They can affect anyone, regardless of age, gender, or social status. These problems can be deliberating. They lead to a life of misery, which can be heard or escaped from. And if you have a testimony today or any other time, please email us our testimony. Next week, we'll be sharing testimonies that we've received. So email us your testimony so we can receive it and share it with everybody else at hcb@hcbministry.org. That is hcb@hcbministry.org. And in the subject title, put testimony. So that way we can share it with everyone else. You know, because many people have found that strength, hope, and a new lesson on life by turning their faith during their darkest moments. This podcast, we're going to explore how faith can hear stories and help those who are struggling with depression and addiction. We will hear stories from myself, how I have gone through these challenging and come out on the other side. So if you're a loved one who's struggling with this, let's continue, sit back, relax, and enjoy the podcast. So my journey into darkness, struggling with depression and faith, in the depths of despair and hopelessness, my journey starts as I was a racehorse jockey, making lots of money, out there making $50,000 in a month, living the fast life, living the worldly life. Although I had always believed in God, don't get it twisted. It's not, I never lost faith in God. But somehow, somewhere along the way, I just lost, not faith, but I just lost myself in the things of this world. And it was the things of this world that got me caught up. And it was the things of this world that had me put my faith on a shelf because things were going great. I felt I didn't need it. Why do I need faith? I have the things of the world, right? With all this wrapped up into a present, nicely knitted, fast cars, fast life, women, drugs. I was a professional athlete living the life. Until one day when the ultimate unthinkable happened, and within 5 seconds, all that was taken from me. Just 5 seconds. It was all taken from me. And it started my life on a downward spiral that was ultimately out of control. I lost my family, my wife, my kids. Got on drugs. Lost my home. Lost all my money. Lost everything. And I wondered where God was during this whole time. He was there with me, but we're going to get into that. But as I was worried more about drugs and horses and racing, I was worried less about God. So instead of making God my number one, I was making things of the world number one. And when he got me, when I got hurt, and I lost everything. It's like Job, I lost everything that I could imagine. Depression wrapped its icy things around my mind. Just my mind whispered cruel lies and dragged me down to the pits of emptiness. The weight on my chest made it hard to breathe. And the days blurred into a never-ending cycle of numbness and pain. See, addiction is like a shadowy companion. You know, it's promised an escape from the unbearable reality of my existence, it offered fleeting moments of relief, but only to tighten a grip with each passing day. My kids felt became less important. Eventually, the horses even became less important, and even my career as a jockey became less important. But what came important was the deceiving and lies of Satan, the depression and the addiction of how I was going to get high the next day or how I was going to stay high. See, as I navigated through the treacherous waters of mental illness and substance abuse, I felt lost, alone. The darkness that threatened to consume me entirely, leaving me teetering on the edge of oblivion or suicide. But even in my darkest moments, a flicker of hope remained. I remembered I had Jesus on the show. A tiny ember of faith that refused to be extinguished. See, through half a dozen of despairs, I begin to see a glimmer of light on the horizon. And it was in that faint at first, barely perceptible mist of maybe the darkness, but it grew stronger with each step I took towards it. My journey into the darkness was not yet over, but I clung to the light of a lifeline, knowing that I held the promise of redemption and renewal. Little did I know that this glimmer of light would lead me on a path of transforming and healing, guiding me out of the abyss and depression and my addiction. But my journey was far from easy. I wound up getting in trouble, wound up going to jail, wound up being student going to prison for drugs, and it was filled with twists and turns and setbacks and victories. I found the Lord when I was in prison. I did my drug rehab. I got out on probation, did my probation successfully, did my drug rehab successfully. And even going back to riding. But through faith and perseverance, I thought I emerged from the darkness, only to find myself suddenly back in it. So as I share my story of overcoming with others who may be struggling in the shadows, know that once we think we're out of it and that God has brought us out of this, I had to find my faith again. As I hit my knees again and prayed, God, take this from me. And it was then I was arrested again 5 minutes later after I had prayed. 5 minutes after I had prayed, I was arrested again. I was like, God, you didn't have to do it this way, did you? He says, yes, my son, I did. And I learned then, I said, please take this addiction and this depression away from me. And he did. But I learned through all of this that in order for it to work, we must constantly serve him. Every day that we live, we constantly serve him. Every day that we wake up, we have to be reminded to 10:31, do what we do for the glory of God. We cannot let the world sneak back into our lives and ultimately grab a hold of us, because that's what Satan wants us to believe. Oh, you're out of it. Don't worry. Here, occasional drink, or here, you know, you can occasionally get high or hang out with your old friends, or you don't have to do drugs. Just hang out with your old friends. Bad company corrupts good character. We see this. We must make a pivotal moment in our lives where we decide, do we choose faith in God, or do we choose the things of this world and our old friends? See, that turning point in the depths of my struggles was with depression and addiction. I had reached the turning point where that illuminating a path towards healing and transformation, it was during my darkest moments that I found solace in faith and discovered a glimmer of hope that would ultimately guide me towards recovery. Faith becoming my anchor, providing me with a sense of purpose and belief. See, in something greater than myself, in the midst of chaos and despair, I found a source of strength that comforts, that allowed me to navigate the turbulent waters of my emotions. Through prayer and reflection and connecting with Yeshua Messiah, I begin to see a light shining through the darkness. This newfound faith instilled in me a sense of resilience and determination, being born again. Wow. Let me say being born again. To overcome my struggles and embrace a life filled with hope and positivity, we must have the hope and positivity in life to move forward. See, that is how our lives work. And that's how we work in Jesus through Yeshua Messiah. You know, the journey from darkness to light is not easy, nor will it ever be an easy one. And there were many obstacles along the way. However, by holding on to my faith and trusting in the power of hope and in trusting in Yeshua Messiah and my prayer life and my relationship, I was able to transcend my circumstances and emerge stronger on the other side. Now, finding faith in my darkest moments was truly a turning point in my life, marking the beginning of a transformational journey towards healing and recovery and a renewed sense of purpose. Renewed sense of purpose. You must have a renewed sense of purpose every day. Because if you don't, the world will creep in. It is something that must be done every day. Every day you wake up, you must renew your sense of purpose. You must renew your relationship with Yeshua Messiah. It must renew your relationship with God. You must renew your relationship with your prayers. See, the role in overcoming depression and addiction, faith can play a powerful role in the journey of overcoming depression and addiction. For many individuals, turning their faith provides a source of strength, hope, and during these challenging times, believing in a higher power or a purpose can offer comfort and solace. When facing the depths of despair and the grip of addiction, faith can serve as a guiding light, providing a sense of meaning and direction in life. It can instill a sense of purpose and a belief that there is a greater plan beyond one's current struggles. See, through prayer, meditation, and seeking spiritual guidance, individuals can find inner peace and a sense of connection to something greater than themselves, as I did. Moreover, faith can foster a sense of community and support. Being part of a faith-based community, in AAA, Bible studies, church, that can offer a network of caring individuals who provide encouragement, understanding, and companionship along with your journey to recovery. This sense of belonging and acceptance can be instrumental in breaking the cycle of isolation, which is very important, and the shame that often accompanies depression and addiction. We must overcome that. We do that by with the people that we surround us with. Make new friends, people. Go out there. You know, ultimately, faith can serve as a beacon of hope in darkness, guiding individuals towards healing, transformation, a renewed sense of purpose. See, by embracing our faith and leaning on its teachings and principles, we can find the strength and courage to overcome the challenges of depression and addiction. And we can emerge into the light of a brighter and healthier future through our faith, through Yeshua, Messiah. You know, he wants us to become better. We can't let the depression and the addiction consume us and let the world consume us. Let's look around and see what we have around us. We see rumors of wars. We see earthquakes happening, 700 earthquakes. We see all this happening. Pestles. We see COVID-19 hit. We see wars. Our government falling apart. America falling apart. America, are we ready for what is fixing to happen? Are you ready for Yeshua the Messiah to come back? Are you ready for all this? Don't let the world, the burden of the world, increase your depression. But actually, use that to your advantage to help you come out of depression and addiction. In the knowing that Yeshua Messiah, the second coming, is at hand, and soon we will be with the Lord. But in order for us to be with him, we must first follow him. We must first accept him into our heart. See, the first step to embrace with acknowledge and embrace like my struggles at accepting that I needed help was the self-awareness of the pivotal moment that allowed me to confront my inner demons and seek support from loved ones and professionals and God. Yes, and God. Next, I prioritized my mental and physical well-being by adopting a healthy habits such as regular exercise, mindfulness practice, and proper nutrition. These lifestyles changed not only to improve my overall health, but also to nurture a sense of self-care and self-worth. We must believe in ourselves. Additionally, I delved into the therapy and counseling to address the root causes of the depression and addiction, but through retrospect and guidance, I explored past traumas, learning coping mechanisms, and developing a resilience in the face of adversity, which was, you know, I developed how to handle things through faith and prayer. Moreover, my faith played a profound role in my journey towards healing, connecting with my spiritual beliefs, providing me with hope, strength, and a renewed sense of purpose. I may no longer be a jockey, but I'm still out there with prayer and meditation and reflecting, becoming intriguing tools to my recovery process. I am offering solace and guidance during a moment of darkness to others, showing others that, yes, I may not be a professional athlete no more making tons of money, but I am a warrior of Christ, a pastor who is out to save lives, to help you understand that it's not over yet, that your depression and your addiction is just the beginning of your new life. It's time to put it down, break free from the chains of depression and addiction, and you do this by requiring perseverance, patience, and willingness, and know that Rome was not built overnight, brick by brick, to embrace vulnerability by taking these steps towards healing and recovering. We not only find our inner peace to be liberation, but also discovered a newfound sense of empowerment and resilience to navigate life's challenges with grace and courage. How many of us want to put down that depression? How many of us want to put down that addiction? We can do that through our faith. Very easy. And we can also do it by finding support. Your AA meeting, your NA meeting, go to those meetings. Go to a Bible study. Go to your church. Finding support in community is one's faith can be transformative and healing. See, experiencing for those struggling with depression and addiction in the depths of despair, it is often the unwavering support of a community bonded by faith that can provide solace and strength to carry on. See, those shared beliefs, prayers, and encouragement individuals can find a sense of belonging and understanding that transcends their personal struggles. It overcomes their personal struggles, whether it's through attending religious services, joining support groups within their faith community, or simply reaching out to fellow believers and guidance to maybe power a communal support in times of darkness that cannot be underestimated. See, faith can serve as a guiding light, offering hope or sense or purpose to navigating the challenges and despairs for addiction by leaning on the pillars of their faith and surrounding themselves with the supportive community. Individuals can find strength and perseverance, heal, and ultimately emerge from the shadows into the light of renewal. You may say, well, Pastor, that's great, but I'm an addict or I'm suffering depression, but I have no way to find support or community. I have no way to get there. I have no ride to go to support groups. I don't know anybody. Well, if you're listening to this podcast, yes, you do. Send us an email that you'd like to get connected. hcb@hcbministries.org. That's hcb@hcbministries.org. Or look online. There's even AA groups who are online that you can go to meetings online as well. Be sure to check those out. You know, so there's many ways that we can foster our addiction and overcome our addiction, as well as overcoming our depression with addiction. There's many different ways, you know, so let us understand that. Let us also understand that prayer and meditation, it played a pivotal role in my journey from darkness to light. It guided me through the shadows of depression and addiction towards a path of healing and renewal in depth of despair when it felt like there was no way out. Turning to faith and seeking solace in prayer provided me with a sense of peace and comfort, suppressed every understanding that I could imagine. When I got depressed, I prayed. When I wanted to get high, I prayed. You know, and they say with the human mind, 10 minutes of thinking of something else, your mind, your body forgets about the addiction for that moment. Well, true enough, but if you spend 10 minutes with just the Lord, our Yeshua, Messiah, our Lord and Jesus Christ, spend 10 minutes with him in prayer, there's nothing you can't overcome. So next time you're depressed, try it. Get on your knees in just 10 minutes of your day praying to him while you're depressed. And ask him, talk to him like a best friend. Just talk to him and see where it goes. Or the next time you want to get high or stick a needle in your arm or do another shot or do another hit because you can't handle your life, get on your knees and pray for 10 minutes. See where that takes you, because through the practice of meditation and prayer, I found a quiet space within myself where I could confront my inner demons and tell them, get behind me, Satan, for you don't know what you're doing. You have no authority over me. I acknowledged all my struggles and cultivated a sense of mindfulness that allowed me to stay present in the Lord. By grounding myself in prayer, I connected with Yeshua, Messiah, Jesus Christ, that offered me strength, hope, and courage to face my challenges head on. And I was okay for a short amount of time. I needed it again. I felt like I wanted to get high again. There for a moment, I survived minute by minute, 10 minutes by 10 minutes, an hour by an hour. I survived it through prayer. Oh, I got to go get high. Oh, I'm so depressed. Oh, I want to miss this. Oh, I want to die. I get down on my knees and I pray 10 minutes. And then it occupied my mind long enough to forget it. Pretty soon, 10 minutes led on to 20 minutes. 20 minutes led to an hour. 1 hour led to 2 hours. You get the picture. 1 day led to 2 days. Pretty soon prayer took over and the devil was gone. See, that's what I'm talking about, the power of prayer and meditation. In my recovery, I cannot overstate the spiritual practices became my anchors in the storm, provided me with a sense of purpose, guidance, and resilience to navigate the rocky terrain of my mental health journey in moments of doubt and despair. I tuned in to Yeshua Messiah and turned to prayer for reassurance, drawing upon my wellspring of faith that sustained me through the darkest of nights. And it can also sustain you through the darkest of nights. Just pray, people. And you know, as I reflected on the transformative impact of prayer and meditation in my life, I realized that these practices not only served as tools for self-care and introspection, but also as a gateway to deeper connection with my Lord Yeshua Messiah, Jesus Christ. Through the simple act of prayer, I found that lifeline to hope, a beacon of light that illuminated the path towards recovery and wholeness that was once so darkened by despair and depression and addiction and drugs, where I thought there was no light. See, embracing the power of prayer and meditation, I discovered a source of strength within myself that transcended and illuminated my circumstances with faith as my compass and my meditation, as Jesus Yeshua as the guide. I embarked on a journey of healing and transformation that led me from the depths of despair to the heights of redemption. Today, I stand as a testament to enduring power of prayer and meditation in overcoming adversity and embracing the light that shines with us all. It is He who shines through us, but it is us who can save those from darkness. All those that you know that are addicted for drugs or depression, let His light shine through you, and you shine through them, and pull them out. See, don't think it's going to be all easy and everything, because I learned that life is full of ups and downs, setbacks, inevitable part of a journey we face with challenges such as despair and addiction. It can be easy to lose hope and feel overwhelmed. However, it is during these difficult times that staying strong in faith can make all the difference in the world, especially now. Overcoming setbacks requires a steadfast belief in something greater than yourself. We must have something greater than ourselves. For many, faith serves as a guiding light, providing solace, strength, and a sense of purpose through faith. Individuals can find the courage to persevere even when the road ahead seems dark and uncertain. Staying connected in faith is not always easy, especially in the face of adversity. In the world today, where it's unpopular to believe in Yeshua, Messiah, Jesus Christ, how church is unpopular, Christian is unpopular, and for us to stay strong in that faith, it's not always easy. It requires trust in a higher power, in Yeshua, Messiah, the Lord, our living God, the true and one living God, a willingness to surrender control to that God, to Yeshua Messiah, and a commitment to self-reflection and growth, not just one-time commitment, but a daily commitment, a daily growth, a daily self-reflection. And by turning to faith during challenging times, individuals can tap into the wellspring of the inner strength and the resilience that can help them navigate even the darkest days. If you wake up today and you say 10:31, you wake up, everything you do is 10:31. Okay, well, I'm going to go do this. Ask yourself, is that 10:31? Does it glorify God? Am I living to glorify God? And by doing that, you ultimately overcome setbacks and you stay strong in faith. And that's a journey of self-discovery and spiritual growth that you have yet to find in a succumbing of peace and joy that is beyond your imagination, beyond your thinking. And by holding on to faith as a beacon of hope and guidance, individuals can find the strength to overcome their struggles and emerge stronger and more resilient on the other side. True? See, shining a bright light through yourself and letting Yeshua Messiah shine through you, and also sharing personal experiences can be incredibly powerful and inspiring. When it comes to overcoming challenges such as despair and addiction, sharing your story can offer hope and encouragement to others who may be going through similar struggles by opening up about your own journey. You not only provide a sense of solidarity to those facing similar battles, but you also break the stigma surrounding mental health and addiction issues. Sharing your story can help others realize that they are not alone in their struggles, and that there is a light at the end of the tunnel. It can serve as a beacon of hope for those who may feel lost, overwhelmed by their circumstances. Your experience, triumphs, and setbacks can offer valuable insights and lessons to others who are on the journey towards healing and recovery, and even to those who aren't. We must be strong, not for ourselves, but for everyone else around us too. And we do that by sharing our story. We create a platform of empathy, understanding, and connection. We can inspire others to seek help, reach out for support, and believe in their own ability to overcome adversity. See, your story has the power to touch hearts, change lives, and make a positive impact in the lives of those who need it most. Embrace the opportunity to share your journey, your testimony, from darkness to light. It's a great one. It's a profound one. It's one that can change lives. As it changed yours, let it change others. And let your story be a source of strength and inspiration for others on the path of healing and wholeness. Don't let it stop there. Let it continue to grow. Continue to fester. Let your story be the light for others. You know, embrace a new life of light. You know, joy through faith is a transformation journey that offers hope and healing to those struggling with depression and addiction. For many individuals, faith serves as a guiding light that illuminates a path towards recovery and renewal. It provides solace in times of darkness, strength in moments of weakness, and a sense of purpose and meaning amidst chaos, right? So through faith, individuals are able to find a deeper connection to something greater than themselves. Whether it be Yeshua Messiah, a higher power, spiritual beliefs, or a community of like-minded individuals, this connection fosters a sense of belonging and support that is crucial in the journey towards healing. Faith offers a beacon of hope in times of despair, reminding individuals that they are never alone and that there is always a possibility for a brighter tomorrow. It instills a sense of resilience and perseverance, empowering individuals to overcome the challenges they face and embrace a new way of living, filled with light, joy, and purpose. by embracing faith, people, we can foster a source of strength and guidance that individuals can embark on transformative and transform their journey as well. Through our light, as self-discovery, healing, and renewal. If I can do it, you can do it. If he can do it, I can do it. See, it propounds the foundation which a new life of light and joy can be built by offering a path toward a brighter and more fulfillment and more fulfilling future. See, I want us to understand that in order to help those who are lost, or even ourselves, sharing our journey or creating a journey for us, maybe create you a journey journal, which is every step of your journey, you write it down. Keep a journal of your steps towards recovery, as your steps towards beating addiction and depression. And keep a journal from your darkness to light. And you can title it My Darkness, From My Darkness to My Light, or whatever you choose. But that can be a powerful way to inspire others who are struggling in the same challenges. Be openly discussing how faith played a pivotal part or role in a recovery from depression to addiction. Write a book. Share your journal. Share your insights of how you have the opportunity that offers hope and healing to those whom you feel lost or alone, and how your own battles became victories, and how your faith-based recovery is a deeply personal transformation processed by that can believe in individuals, see, with a sense of purpose, strength, and guidance as we navigate our way towards healing by sharing our experiences and in the ways in which our faith is supported on us and our journey, we can help those others see that there is a light. We can be that light. We can be the Bible that someone may never read. We can be the Jesus that someone may never see. And ultimately, we can be the light at the end of the tunnel, and that they are not alone in their struggles. So through your words and actions today, as we move forward in this podcast and as we come to a close, you have the power to inspire others to embark on their own path towards healing and renewal by offering a message of hope, faith, and you can help individuals and offer to find their strength with themselves to overcome their challenges and emerge stronger and more resilient to the other side. Let us encourage people to enjoy our story and to share our story as the potential to become a beacon of light for those who are still searching for the way out of the darkness, guiding them towards a brighter and more hopeful future. If you would like to share your testimony, I highly encourage you. Shoot us an email with your testimony, hcb@hcbministries.org. That's hcb@hcbministries.org. We would love to share your testimony. Now, with that concluding our podcast today, we would like to close in prayer. So if everybody bow their head with me and pray. Heavenly Father, we come to the end of this episode of Faith Foundation Podcast. We lift up our hearts and voices to you in prayer. We thank you for being our guiding light in times of darkness, for showing us the way from despair to hope, and for being our strength in moments of weakness. Today, we have delved into the topics of overcoming depression and addiction through faith, and we have been reminded of the power of your love and grace in transforming lives. Lord, we pray for all those who are battling with depression and addiction. We ask for your healing touch to be upon them, to lift the heavy burdens they carry, and to fill them with your peace that surpasses all understandings. Help them to see that the light at the end of the tunnel, to hold on to hope, and to know that they are never alone, for you are always with them. We pray for those who are struggling in darkness, that they may find strength and reach out for help to seek treatment and to lean on to their faith for support. May they be surrounded by loving and caring individuals who will walk alongside them on their journey to recovery. Give them the courage to face their challenges head on, and perseverance to never give up, knowing that with you, all things are possible. Philippians 4:13. Lord, we also pray for the families and the loved ones those who are battling depression and addiction. Help them to be strong and supportive, to show understanding and patience, and to never lose faith in the transformation that you can bring about their loved ones' lives. Grant them the wisdom and guidance in how to best help and encourage those who are struggling, and fill their hearts with compassion and empathy. As we conclude this episode, as we ask for your blessings on all those who have listened today, may the words spoken and the stories shared inspire and encourage them in their own journeys of faith. May they find comfort in knowing that there is always hope, always a way out of the darkness, and always a light to shining bright to guide them home. We thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to come together in fellowship, to struggle and to share our struggles and the triumphs, and to be reminded of your unwavering love for us. May this podcast continue to be a beacon of hope and a source of strength to all who listen. In your holy, precious name, Yeshua Messiah, the one and only Jesus Christ, we pray, and we all said, Amen. From IHCB Ministries Faith Foundation Podcast, we're grateful for your listenership. I'm Pastor Joseph Holmes, and privileged to be your host for this podcast.